Tell me about yourself. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Jun here with Hapa Eikaiwa. 今日は7人の先生たちに仕事の面接を想定した動画を撮ってもらいました。アメリカで仕事のインタビューに行くと、必ずと言っていいほど聞かれる一発目の質問が、Tell me about yourself. 自分のことについて話してください。自己紹介をしてください。いきなりこういった質問をされると一瞬戸惑いますよね。なんて答えたらいいのか、自分の学歴を話すべきなのか、経歴、実績、出身地、趣味について話すのか、なんてこの質問に答えるべきなのか、今日は先生たちにオンライン習い事サイトカフェトークの面接を受けていることを想像して動画を撮ってもらいました。まず最初に字幕なしで先生たちの面接動画を流しますので、どこまで聞き取れるかチャレンジをしてください。後半は私の解説を入れながら字幕入りの面接動画を流します。さあ、先生たちはどのように Tell me about yourself に答えるのでしょうか。 Let's watch and find out.
Hi, thank you for inviting me to this interview. Please let me tell you a little bit about myself. I've been an online English teacher for over 10 years.
Hi, so my name is Becca and I am from Calgary in Canada.And I studied psychology and political science in university because I was very interested in how the world works and how people work.
My name is Tan Lee and I was born in the United States of America. I currently live in Las Vegas, Nevada. I went to school, graduated with a degree in anthropological linguistics as well as Japanese.
Hello, my name is Christian. I'm from a small town in South Georgia in the United States called Wake Ross.I grew up in South Georgia and I went to college in South Georgia as well. I studied Japanese and I studied international trade while I was in college, and I studied abroad in Japan for 1 year.
My name is Monica Marshall and I'm from Canada. In Canada, I taught as an elementary teacher for 5 years, and in Japan, I've been teaching English for the past 2 years.
Hey, my name is Brian and I'm from the USA. I've been living abroad in Thailand for about 6 years now.And I am an English teacher here in Thailand.
Cynthia, I'm from Boston, Massachusetts, where I grew up in a very multicultural environment. I attended Boston University for my master's degree in English and Language Arts Education.
After I graduated college, I came back to Japan about a year ago, a little bit over a year ago. And I currently work as a translation coordinator and a translator.At a Japanese company.
After university, I moved to Quebec and started teaching elementary school children English. I stayed mainly in the ESL field for the past almost 10 years now in a variety of roles. So I've been a coordinator, I've been a teacher, I've been a monitor, I've developed curriculum, I've done lots of stuff.
I've developed over 20 online classes ranging from basic English conversation classes to more advanced professional counseling classes.
In Canada, I taught grades 3 and 5. And here in Japan, I teach English to students from grades 1 to 6.
After gaining experience as an educator in the U.S., I decided to pursue my passion for travel and traveled abroad to China,Hong Kong, Taiwan, to bring my teaching experience there and to gain more cultural insight into the world outside the U.S.
I also do some writing on the side as a freelancer. In my free time, I like to go to the gym, travel around Japan, and watch movies.
I have a wide variety of hobbies that I'm very passionate about, like playing guitar and also...sports, exercise, reading. I love reading books.
I speak intermediate French and Japanese, and I'm still learning. And I love volunteering. That's my main hobby, is I volunteer at a bunch of organizations. I love reading, and I love, I'm actually a filmmaker, so I make films for immigrants right now.
I've studied 6 different languages, and I just wanted to be able to communicate with people from all different cultures and backgrounds. I believe that the best way to build a relationship with someone is to speak their native language. And through my experience, I've seen that happen many, many times.
I really like to be outside, and I love hiking and skiing. And I also like to do bouldering indoors.
I believe in this time of the COVID-19 crisis, that online learning has become more important than ever, and I'm committed to bringing my students the best possible educational opportunity they can have. I think I would be a great addition to your staff. Thank you.
いかがでしたか？先生たちのインタビューは聞き取れましたか？字幕入りの動画を流す前にキーフレーズをいくつか解説していきたいと思います。まず、自己紹介に入る前に。
Hi. Thank you for inviting me to this interview.
Thank you for inviting me to this interview. 日本語の場合、お忙しいところ面接のお時間をいただきありがとうございますというのが一般的だと思いますが、英語の場合、Thank you for inviting me to this interview. このインタビューに招待していただきありがとうございますというのが一般的です。このフレーズを言わずにいきなり自己紹介に入ってもいいのですが、この一言はかなり丁寧な響きがあり、相手に好印象を与えるので、個人的にはおすすめします。次は名前と出身地の伝え方。
My name is Monica Marshall and I'm from Canada.
Hey, my name is Brian and I'm from the USA.
Cynthia, I'm from Boston, Massachusetts.
Hi, so my name is Becca and I am from Calgary in Canada.
名前を伝える場合は、I'm 何々。My name is 何々どちらを使っても OK ですが My name is 何々の方がよりフォーマルな響きがあります出身地はシンプルに I'm from 何々 I'm from の後には国名もしくは都市名が入りますもしあまり知られていない田舎の町が出身の場合は
I'm from a small town in South Georgia in the United States called Waycross
I'm from a small town in Japan called UchinadaSmall town in の後には国、called の後には町の名前を入れるだけで OK です。次は学歴の伝え方。
I studied psychology and political science in university.
I studied Japanese and I studied international trade while I was in college.
大学の専攻をカジュアルに伝える言い方が I studied 何々。私は大学で経済と会計を専攻したので I studied economics and accounting.ちなみに、ベッカは University、クリスチャンは College と呼びましたが、両方とも大学を意味します。一般的には University の方が College より規模が大きいですが、アメリカは大きさに限らず大学全般を College と表す傾向があるように思います。アメリカ以外は University と呼ぶことが多いように感じます。I studied よりももうちょっとフォーマルな言い方が、
I went to school, graduated with a degree in anthropological linguistics as well as Japanese.
I graduated with a degree in 何々。何々の学位を取得しました。その他にも、I majored in 何々。何々を専攻しましたと表現することができ。I graduated with a degree in economics and accounting. I majored in economics and accounting.次は仕事や経歴の伝え方。前職について説明をするときは
In Canada, I taught as an elementary teacher for 5 years.
I taught as an elementary school teacher for 5 years. I was an elementary school teacher for 5 years. と意味は同じですが I taught as の形式を使った方がよりフォーマルな響きがあります。同じ形式を使って仕事について話すときは
And I currently work as a translation coordinator.
I currently work as a translation coordinator. もし会計士として働いている場合は I currently work as an accountant. ソフトウェアエンジニアとして働いている場合は I currently work as a software engineer. のように work as の後には職名を入れるだけで OK です。ちなみに currently は入れなくても問題ありません。currently を入れることによって現在はという部分を強調しています。しばらくの期間、今の仕事をしていると言いたい場合は
I've been an online English teacher for over 10 years.
And in Japan, I've been teaching English for the past 2 years.
過去に何かを始め、今でもそれを続けていると表したいときに I've been 何々 for 何々 years と言います。例えば私は10年以上英語を教えているので I've been teaching English for over 10 years.もし、この3年間英語を教えていますと言いたい場合は、I've been teaching English for the past 3 years のように、for の後には the past を入れます。I've been はこんな風に使うこともできます。
So So I've been a coordinator, I've been a teacher, I've been a monitor.
I've been a coordinator, I've been a teacher, I've been a monitor. 今はコーディネーターをしていない、今は先生をやっていない、今はモニターをしていないけど、過去にやったことがあり、今後もそれを再開する可能性があることを示します。次は何語を話せるかを伝える言い方を見てみましょう。
I speak intermediate French and Japanese, and I'm still learning.
I speak intermediate French and Japanese, and I'm still learning. ここのキーポイントは最後の I'm still learning。自分の英語に自信がなくても It's not that good と言わないようにここはポジティブな言い方に変えて I'm still learning や I'm still working on it と言った方がいい印象を与えます I can speak a little English I'm still working on it 次は趣味の伝え方
In my free time, I like to go to the gym, travel around Japan, and watch movies
I really like to be outside and I love hiking and skiing.
And I love volunteering, that's my main hobby.
自分の趣味を伝えるときはシンプルに I like 何々もしくは I love 何々私はバスケが大好きなので I love to play basketball もしくは I love playing basketball どちらの形式を使っても OK です次は最後の締め言葉
I think I would be a great addition to your staff.Thank you.
I think I would be a great addition to your staff. Thank you. 自己紹介をこの一言で終わらせると印象アップするでしょう。Staff の代わりに Team や Company を使っても OK です。それでは次は字幕入りの動画を流します。先ほど紹介したフレーズが聞き取れるかチェックをしましょう。
Hi. Thank you for inviting me to this interview. Please let me tell you a little bit about myself.I've been an online English teacher for over 10 years.
Hi, so my name is Becca and I am from Calgary in Canada. And I studied psychology and political science in university because I was very interested in how the world works and how people work.
My name is Tan Lee and I was born in the United States of America. I currently live in Las Vegas, Nevada. I went to school, graduated with a degree in anthropological linguistics as well as Japanese.
Hello, my name is Christian. I'm from a small town in South Georgia in the United States called Waycross. I grew up in South Georgia and I went to college in South Georgia as well.I studied Japanese and I studied international trade while I was in college and I studied abroad in Japan for 1 year.
My name is Monica Marshall and I'm from Canada. In Canada, I taught as an elementary teacher for 5 years and in Japan, I've been teaching English for the past 2 years.
Hey, my name is Brian and I'm from the USA. I've been living abroad in Thailand for about 6 years now and I am an English teacher here in Thailand.
Cynthia, I'm from Boston, Massachusetts, where I grew up in a very multicultural environment. I attended Boston University for my master's degree in English and Language Arts Education.
After I graduated college, I came back to Japan about a year ago, a little bit over a year ago, and I currently work as a translation coordinator and a translator at a Japanese company.
After university,I moved to Quebec and started teaching elementary school children English. I stayed mainly in the ESL field for the past almost 10 years now in a variety of roles. So I've been a coordinator, I've been a teacher, I've been a monitor, I've developed curriculum, I've done lots of stuff.
I've developed over 20 online classes ranging from basic English conversation classesto more advanced professional counseling classes.
In Canada, I taught grades 3 and 5. And here in Japan, I teach English to students from grades 1 to 6.
After gaining experience as an educator in the US, I decided to pursue my passion for travel and traveled abroad to China, Hong Kong, Taiwan,to bring my teaching experience there and to gain more cultural insight into the world outside the U.S.
I also do some writing on the side as a freelancer. In my free time, I like to go to the gym, travel around Japan, and watch movies.
I have a wide variety of hobbies that I'm very passionate about, like playing guitar and also sports, exercise, reading. I love reading books.
I speak intermediate French and Japanese, and I'm still learning. And I love volunteering. That's my main hobby, as I volunteer at a bunch of organizations. I love reading, and I'm actually a filmmaker, so I make films for immigrants right now.
I've studied six different languages, and I just wanted to be able to communicate with people from all different cultures and backgrounds. I believe that the best way to build a relationship with someone is to speak their native language. And through my experience, I've seen that happen many, many times.
I really like to be outside, and I love hiking and skiing, and I also like to do bouldering indoors.
I believe in this time of the COVID-19 crisis that online learning has become more important than ever, and I'm committed to bringing my students the best possible educational opportunity they can have. I think I would be a great addition to your staff. Thank you.
Tell me about yourself に対する返答の仕方は人それぞれで、正しい返答の仕方はありませんが、今回の動画でほとんどの人は自分の名前、出身地、学歴、経歴、そして趣味について話しました。しかしここでマストではないのが出身地と学歴です。今回は世界各地に住んでいる先生のインタビューだったので、皆さん自分の出身地をお伝えしましたが、自分が住んでいる国でインタビューをする場合は出身地を伝える必要はないでしょう。もし海外でのオンラインインタビューをする場合は出身地を伝えても OK です。また今回の動画で自分の学歴を言った人と言わなかった人がいます。これは個人の経験から言えることなのですが、学歴を言う人は一般的に大学を卒業したばかりの若い人たちが多いように思います。もうちょっと年を重ねていろんなところで仕事をし始めると、自分の学校の話よりもこれまで仕事してきた話の内容、そこで学んできたこと、得てきたスキルについて話す方が一般的だと思います。 Tell me about yourself に対する返答は1分から2分程度を目安にするといいでしょう。今回協力してくれた先生たちの動画も全て1分ちょっとでした。過去、現在、そして今後の意気込みを1分から2分程度でまとめることをお勧めします。私は英会話学校を経営していますので、これまでたくさんの先生たちにインタビューをしてきました。インタビューから言えるのは、経歴や学歴をチェックするのではなく、どちらかというと人間性を個人的にチェックしているように思います。学歴や経歴は履歴書を見ればすぐ分かることなのですが、相手がどんな人なのか、どんな性格なのか、自分の会社のカルチャーに合うタイプなのかをチェックする場だと考えています。なので、あまり情報とか事実にこだわりすぎず、これまでの学歴とか経歴、前職で学んできたことは何なのか、自分はこれから何をしたいのかという気持ちを伝えた方が、よりインタビューする側としては響くように思います。また今回のインタビューでも皆さん趣味について話しましたが、やはり趣味について話すことによってよりその人の人間性が出るので、趣味も必ず伝えることをお勧めします。何より自分らしくいることがベストだと思います。 Tell me about yourself の質問に慣れていないと最初は大変だと思いますが、いい意味でも悪い意味でも、アメリカの会社や海外の会社でインタビューをすると、必ずと言っていいほど聞かれる一番目の質問です。なので、事前に準備をし、1分から2分を目安に Tell me about yourself に対する返答を書いて練習することをお勧めします。練習をすればするほど、やればやるほど楽になっていき、やればやるほどどんどんどんどん考えなくても Tell me about yourself に対してパッと言えるようになります。 Just remember, be yourself。 頑張ってください。今日の動画に協力してくれた先生たちはみんなオンライン習い事サイト、カフェトークの英語の先生です。みんな楽しい英会話レッスンを教えています。先生たちのプロフィールは下に貼っていますので、興味のある方はぜひチェックしてください。 Thank you guys for watching today. You guys have an awesome day, and I'll catch you guys again next time. Take it easy, guys. Peace.